The University of Central Florida is like many large urban universities, but it's also unusual in that its main campus, east of Orlando, features an arboretum encompassing more than 80 acres. To maintain the health of this ecosystem, managers utilize many tools, among them, controlled burns.
Well, most of the habitats and natural systems in Florida are either fire dependent or fire influenced, and that's a normal process in their management. So we try to mimic that by doing prescribed fires to burn down the fuel load and to increase biodiversity on the site.
Intentionally setting a fire in a densely populated area is not done haphazardly. Managers carefully monitor winds and humidity. They also rely on small test fires to determine whether it's safe to proceed.
What we're doing here is we're lighting the test fire. We have a really high relative humidity first thing this morning, and we're just lighting the test fire to make sure that the smoke is going to disperse and the wind is coming out of the right direction.
So we'll run in and drip little drips of fire on the ground to kind of get the burn going, and we try and do that as slow as possible to make sure that the fire doesn't get too intense and the flames don't get too high, because when that happens, then we kill off more plants than we want to.
Understanding this environment helps the crew anticipate how the fire will behave.
We have a pine flatwoods ecosystem that we were dealing with, and with palmetto gallberry, and there can be a lot of fuel loading.
I am really familiar with this area since I work here every day. I know some areas that are more dense with wooded species, so I felt kind of a duty to make sure that that area got burned off a little more than some of the other areas. So I was really huffing and puffing out there trying to get through that dense brush and make sure that got burned up.
First of all, we want to control the fire. That's our main goal. And one of our targets is to get good coverage and burn up this fuel that has accumulated over the last several years since the last fire. So we're taking our time making sure the fire encompasses most of the unit.
And there's fuel that can also go up in the air and drift for a quarter mile down the road. And so you have to be aware of what this palmettos and palm fronds that you're burning here, but you have to be aware that if the wind picks up or if this stuff is catching and going up in the air and staying lit, that down the road you may have a problem.
All the oils are coming out of them, and that's when.
I also help to make sure we don't see spot overs, which is when the burn gets out of the unit that we're burning in. So always keeping eyes and ears behind and around where the fire isn't supposed to be to make sure that it hasn't spotted over.
During the burn, the crew continuously monitors the weather.
My role during the burn is to be on the lookout crew and circle the unit that's burning in order to relay dispersion rates, temperature, relative humidity, wind direction, wind speed, and wind gust to the team so that they can adjust the reaction to the fire.
This being an urban area, the goal is to keep smoke off the roads and out of the neighborhoods.
Our biggest lesson probably from this burn was managing the smoke. We had some issues with working around logistics on campus. We had to make sure that was executed in that way so we didn't impact the university or any of its functions during that process.
In addition to maintaining the ecosystem, the burns provide an opportunity for public education.
The day after, we usually do a guided hike, or within the next couple of days, because we want people who have seen that unit before it was burned to again see that unit right after it's burned. That gives us an opportunity to show them what it is we do.
As I explained before, it's a pyrophytic ecosystem. So this ecosystem is very, very well adapted to frequent fires. This saw palm, for instance, also known as Serranoa repens is the genus and species name. This plant can grow back in 2 weeks after a burn's occurred. And the reason it's able to do that is because you see all these burnt, basically the roots. See all these roots down here? Those are all called rhizomes, above ground horizontal root systems that connect a community of different saw palms.
Just a few weeks after the burn, new life is already sprouting through the ashes.
Since we did our burn 3 weeks ago, we've noticed a lot of new growth occurring, especially with grasses and some of these ground covers, which is really what we were after by doing this controlled burn. We needed to burn down some of the heavier woody vegetation to open up space for the ground covers that are coming in today.
The plants in Florida depend on fire. A lot of seeds won't germinate without the heat of fire. A lot of the ground forbs won't be able to get sun and grow, and that's something that gopher tortoises and other small animals and mammals depend on. So without fire, a lot of the Florida ecosystem just doesn't work.
Watch full episodes of SciTech Central, Thursdays at 8:30 p.m.